So, it's been a little while, hasn't it? I think the last time you saw me was probably sitting in this position about 3 weeks ago, maybe even four now. I've had a little break. I only planned to have a week's break, but ended up being 3 weeks, just because I've been so busy at work, and I just literally haven't had time to fit vlogging in. And the content would have been so boring just because I'm always at work and obviously I can't film there. But a few people have been like, when's your vlogs coming back? So I've decided that let's give it another go. You haven't missed a lot in my life. I'm trying to think of what's been going on the last 3 weeks. So as I say, I've worked a lot. I've been spending every second that I can with Adam, just because I haven't really been seeing him either, even though we work at the same place. We've paid Disney off. We paid Disney off last Monday, so £5,000 down the drain. But it will be so worth it, and it now seems that tiny, tiny bit more real. And we only have about 83 more days to go. It's just flying round. Like, when we booked it, it was like 385, and now the 300 days has disappeared and we're on the final stretch. So that's that. I finally finished Apple Tree Yard. I know some people would be like, whoa, but they won't. And I've started a new book called Baby Doll. I started it last night and I'm already like halfway through. See, I can read fast, but when I have the time. What else has been going on? Tomorrow is Easter Sunday, shock horror. I can have chocolate again. 6.5 weeks of not having chocolate has absolutely killed me. But yeah, so I'm really, really excited for that. But I'm off to work in a minute, so here we go. Let's roll the 7th weekly vlog.
So excuse the rubbish in our living room, but look what's happened. I literally woke up this morning and there's Easter eggs all over the floor. None of them are for me, apparently. But Adam had a little splurge and he's decided to buy, so these three over here are for his mum, dad and sister. These four here are for my mum and dad, and my granddad and uncle. And then these two at the front, one's for my best friend Ellie, and then he has a spare.
So I was like, why did you buy so many? And he was like, oh, they were three for £10, so I bought 9. Okay. Thanks for that. Now cluttering up my living room carpet, but they will be gone tomorrow. But I'm so excited to have chocolate. So these are the new sunglasses I bought last week when me and Adam went shopping. I'm not sure if I like them or not. I did at the time because they've got a tiny bit of leopard print. They don't seem to fit my face very well, so I might have to rethink this before Disney, but I'm gonna get to work now because I should have left like 5 minutes ago. Yeah, I'm gonna get to work now. I just got home from work and look what the time is. It's midnight, which means it's Easter, which means I can eat chocolate. So, it's all poised and ready. So my lovely colleague at work, Sue, made everyone chocolate cake tonight. And I'm gonna eat it right now. For the first time in 6.5 weeks, I'm putting chocolate in my mouth. And it's the most amazing feeling. Yeah. But I've really enjoyed Lent, actually. As I said in a few vlogs ago when I gave it up, I give up crisps every year for the last 7 years. And Mum was like, it's not a challenge anymore. And you know what? This has actually been such a challenge. And I've really enjoyed it, that I'm actually thinking of giving it back up after sort of Easter period's over, because I've actually lost 8 or 9 pounds during sort of the last month or so. So yeah, but I'm gonna finish my cake and I'm gonna wait for Adam to get home and go to sleep. But see you tomorrow.
I've just woken up and look what Adam, or the Easter Bunny, has brought me. Laid it all out on the sofa. So, thank you, Adam. You've done a really good job there. An amazing choice of eggs. Thank you.
I don't think I'm going to be able to do this without laughing at you.
Well, I'm not doing nothing.
Hello. It's Sunday. Easter Sunday. Adam doesn't want to be in it because he said he hasn't signed any forms or anything, but I'm going to be in it anyway. Stop it, you're driving. But it's nearly 12 o'clock. We are on our way to Mum and Dad's for a Sunday roast. Excited? It's not good to answer me. And then later we're going to Adam's Mum and Dad's for dinner. And we always seem to do this on like Christmas and stuff. We go to both our parents and we both get a meal, which is really exciting.
I've got ridiculously tired eyes, that's why I've got my glasses on, but it's 11 o'clock at night now, and it's safe to say Easter has happened in the Strathdy War household. Look at this. Oh my god, all of this is eggs full. We've literally got about 15 Easter eggs, maybe like 20 between us. Absolutely crazy. Like, bearing in mind, I don't actually even fancy chocolate because I've not had it for like six and a half weeks. But yeah, it could take a while. We're aiming to eat it all by Florida, but it could be even my birthday, Adam's birthday, August, September time. Good job chocolate doesn't go out of date. But I've had a really, really lovely day today. Had an amazing Sunday roast at Mum and Dad's. Which there was a little clip earlier, and we played logo game, and we played it three times, and Mum and Dad won all three times. My dad was actually on fire today with the games. Normally he's not very confident when we play board games, but he was knowing all the answers. So that was really lovely for them to win, and we were thoroughly spoilt with food and chocolate there. And then this evening we've been to Adam's Mum and Dad's for dinner. And we had trifle, which is my absolute favourite. And what have we been doing? Oh, we've been watching a Bee Gees concert. Adam's mum and dad went to see a Bee Gees show last night at the theatre. And do you know what? I absolutely love the Bee Gees. I've found a newfound love for them. So we've literally just been raving in their front room all evening for about 3 hours. It's been insane. But yeah, it's getting late now and I'm getting tired. So I'm going to go to bed, but also Adam's very happy that Manu won the football today, so he's looking forward to teasing his boss at work tomorrow, because his boss supports Chelsea. But tomorrow, yeah, Adam's at work and I'm not, but I'm going to have a nice catch up with Mum and Dad again. We're going to go shopping, have lunch together, then I'm going to go and see my other granddad, who lives a little bit further away. I haven't seen him, I don't think, since New Year's Day, which was like 4 months ago, which is quite terrible. So I'm going to go and see my other granddad tomorrow and spend some family time with everybody. But yeah, that's it for this evening. See you tomorrow.
Happy Monday. It doesn't feel like Monday, does it? It's a spank holiday, but yeah, happy Monday. I've been awake since 4 a.m. I've somehow contracted a cold in somewhere, which is not great, but I'm not going to moan about it because people say that I always moan that I'm ill. But yeah, so I've been up since 4. I did go back to sleep for a bit, woke up again about 8, so that was alright. But it's 9:30 now, and my mum and dad gave me at 10:30, so I'm just going to watch some TV before I go. I'm probably not going to film today just because I'm going to have some really good family time. That I won't want to get the camera out, so I'll catch up with you when I get home.
As they're all laid out nicely for you, as I've just taken a photo of them, I thought I'd do like a little Easter egg haul. Yeah, as I said last night, those bags were full of chocolate, and this is the end result. I don't think I've ever had this much in my life. I don't quite know what's happened this year. But yeah, me and Adam would just like to thank every single person that gifted us chocolate this Easter, because we've got a lot. So what did we get? So at the back here we've got a dairy milk one with two like massive dairy milks. We've got one each. Well, that's the washing machine just finished. From my mum and dad. Then my granddad bought us a cream egg, big one each. Then Adam's mum and dad bought me the 12 one and Adam the cream egg one. I bought Adam the Mars, the lion, this bunny here, and is that it? Oh, and the Malteser from the celebrations. I got him those as well. He got me the dairy milk caramel, the roses one, the limp bunny, and the golden egg one. People who I work with will know why I've got that one. Our best friends Ellie and Ben bought us Penny and Percy Pig and Piglets. That's nice. My granddad and Nanny bought us the Rolo one. My godparents bought us the Munchy one. Adam's sister bought us the mini eggs and the Kinder and Milky Bar chocolates. My granddad also bought us these little mini bunnies here, and my friend bought me the cream eggs, and someone else I work with called Andy bought us the little woodland one as well. So I think that's it. I really wish that washing machine would shut up.
This is the current situation. It's about 8:45 on Monday evening. I'm in bed, and I have been in bed for about 3 hours now, and I've got my tissues, my nose spray, and my food, and I'm just watching TV. And to be quite honest, I feel quite rough, but there we go. So I think better than cuddling up in bed when you don't feel very well. So I'm just waiting for Broadchurch to start now. A final episode of the final series, so I'm really excited to see who did it and what the outcome is at the end. And then hopefully by the time that finishes, Adam will be well on his way to finish your work and coming home to find a snotty me. I literally just put the camera away from the last clip and Adam walked through the door. So he was home like an hour and 20 minutes early. So we watched Broadchurch together, which was really nice because we watched most of the episodes together. But it was a really, really good last episode, and was not expecting that at all. But I'm going to go to bed now because I've got work tomorrow and I need to rest. See you tomorrow. Hello people, happy Tuesday. It's, I don't even know what time it is, about 5 in the evening? Yeah, okay, we'll go with that, 5. I've just got home from work. It's been quite a long day actually, especially when I've got like, I've just got home from work and I'm going to the theatre tonight with my mum, dad and my auntie to see Ghost the Musical, which is quite exciting. I've never seen the film, so I don't even know what it's about really, but hopefully it'll be really, really good. So I'm just waiting for mum and dad to like text me as to what's happening and if we're eating out or if I'm eating at home or, yeah, so that should be quite fun. Well, excuse the snotty mess and the fan in the background. I'm running such a temperature for my cold, but I just have to talk to you about what I've just experienced. Ghost the Musical was insane. Like, I was enjoying it right up until the last like 5-10 minutes, and then bang, it just hit me and I cried. I absolutely cried like a baby. I knew obviously it was sad and I knew sort of what it was about. Spoiler alert if you don't know what it's about. It's about a couple called Molly and Sam who obviously are in love, and they live like in their own like apartment, and then Sam gets shot, and obviously he dies and he becomes a ghost, and he comes back to sort of see Molly and talk to her and tell her that she's in danger, and he does it through like a psychic medium called Oda Mae Brown. Well, I'm not going to go into like too much detail because if you're not interested, you're not interested, but the last 10 minutes when he's like letting go and like obviously moving on into heaven, that moment, I just thought, wow. And I just, the tears were just running down my face. Like, I'm so glad we were in like a private box thing in the theatre, because it was only my family that got to experience me bawling my eyes out. But when I looked around, my mum and my auntie were both shedding a little tear. So I don't feel as bad now. But yeah, an absolutely amazing show. I think it's the last week of the tour this week, but if it does tour again, and if any of you ever get to see it, I'd highly recommend it. So yeah, Carolyn Maitland played Molly Jensen, and I was just trying to tell my mum and dad this. I think she won West End Frames Understudy of the Year, but I can't remember what show it was for. But I'm so glad that she got the limelight, because she's a fantastic actress. And Andy Moss played Sam Wheat. And I was a little bit unsure, because he'd been in like Hollyoaks and stuff, and I wasn't sure how good he'd be. But he has got an incredible voice, like out of this world. So, oh, and it was such good casting and a really, really good show. But enough about my exciting evening. I'm going to get into bed now, because I've got such a long day tomorrow. I've got like a 14-hour day tomorrow, and I'm still full of cold and feeling great. But yeah, so night night everyone. See you tomorrow. Does everyone like my Coke can display behind me? Yeah, I don't drink Coke. They're not mine. But there you go. Happy Thursday. I've missed a day. This is the current situation. I'm laying on the sofa with my duvet and my pillows and the TV, because I'm so full of cold. Like I said I wasn't going to moan about it, but oh, I hate having a cold. I haven't slept for like 3 nights, so I didn't vlog yesterday because I had a 14-hour day at work, and I also felt like meh, so I didn't pick up the camera. I don't really know what I'm going to say in this part of the vlog, but I obviously want to stay so true to real life, because that's what you guys are seeing. You're seeing my life. But it's 20 past 10 on Thursday evening. I am supposed to be at work. I am not at work. I took very ill this afternoon and therefore couldn't go to work. So I just wanted to keep you guys like informed of what's happening. I'm at home at my mum and dad's now. Basically, Adam went to work about 1:30, and I started to feel very, very poorly once he had left the flat. I got such a blinding headache that I felt sick. I couldn't get up off the bed without wanting to fall on the floor and pass out. I couldn't feel my legs properly. I just didn't know what to do with myself. I don't know what's caused it. I mean, I'm obviously full of cold, as you could probably hear. But basically, obviously, as you know, 2 days ago I came off my tablets that have been treating my shingles, and this morning I went back to the doctors and she's put me back on them, because she said about, obviously, if I come off them, she doesn't want the pain to come back. Obviously, as I've been off them for 2 days now, I think they worked their way out of my system, and it came back with a vengeance. So yeah, I mean, I've had lots and lots of sleep this evening. That's all I can do. I'm feeling okay now. I'm not feeling my best. Like, all my plans I had tomorrow, like dancing, and I was supposed to be having my eyebrows waxed, I've had to cancel, just because I don't want to go through any more pain. I just want to rest more, really. I'm gonna get back into bed now and sleep some more, and hopefully the pain will disappear. But thank you for understanding. Good morning. Well, it's nearly afternoon. Happy Friday. Still looking slightly dishevelled, but feeling quite a lot better today. It's about lunchtime, so I'm just cooking myself some pasta.
before I have to get ready for work this afternoon. Yeah, feeling quite a lot better. This area of my mouth and lips is now completely numb from like having a cold, and I slept probably more than I should have done, but I'm starting to feel like I'm on the mend now.
I just had a shower. Now I'm in bed again watching Amelia's channel on YouTube and having some Easter egg for about a few minutes, and I'm gonna straighten my hair and get ready for work.
It's 12:30 and I've just got in from work. I'm so tired, but just gonna get into bed and check social media like you do, and then I'm going to read a bit more of my book Baby Doll, which I started only like a week ago and really finished it. It's a really, really good book actually. I'd say it's a cross between the book Room by Emma Donoghue, I think that's her name, and the TV show on BBC One called The Missing. It's very similar to both of those, so if you liked either of those, give it a go. But yeah, so that's all I've got to report really. I should really probably start editing this vlog because I don't know how long it's going to be. It's probably going to be either really short or really long. I can never quite get it right. But today I finally decided what I'm going to get my best friend Ellie for her birthday, which is the 21st of May, so it's actually, I'm up today. So Ellie, if you're watching this, your surprise is in the pipeline thanks to a couple of my very special helpers who are helping me plan. So all will be revealed in the next few weekly vlogs. Ellie's like my number one vlog fan. Literally, she just goes on at me all the time, are you vlogging today? Are you vlogging today? And it was really nice at work tonight when my other friend Honor was like, how are your vlogs coming along? And then we all just started a big vlog conversation. Ellie was obviously included. So if you're watching this, guys, I love my work family very much. So we've just got back from the retail park. We didn't get our Nutra Ninja because they didn't have any, but we are going to order it in and get it either delivered or delivered to the store. But Adam did get some trainers from Disney. You probably can't see the colour. They're a really nice red colour. So they're like memory foam ones, which is really handy because I got mine the other day and we couldn't get him any. So he's now got a pair, which, Mum, if you're watching, thank you so much for buying them for Adam. Yeah, so Adam's off to work now and I start a little bit later, so I'm just gonna read my book. I wish I could go to work like this, just in my pyjamas, and not have to worry about wearing like a suit. That'd be so nice. But it's 3:30 in the afternoon. I've just done my hair and makeup. It's the first time I've worn like proper full on makeup all week actually. And I must say I'm quite enjoying it. I might actually put a red lip on as well to complete the look. That's if I can find it, but yeah. So I've just made my dinner and then I'll be leaving for work in about another hour or so. It's about 10 to 5 now and I'm just walking to work. I've just been editing the vlog just before I come out, and the clip this morning that I filmed at the retail park, it went corrupt, so now the footage looks like it doesn't make any sense. Basically our NutriBullet broke, so we can't make smoothies anymore, so we went to get a Nutri Ninja. Basically it didn't have any, hence the second clip this morning. There's so many people around. I'm vlogging public, guys. So yeah, so it's gonna be hopefully a good shift at work tonight. I'm working with obviously my best friend Ellie, so woohoo. But yeah, I'll catch up with you when I finish. I'm not sure how nice this angle is because the clip before this, the angle is so horrible and I have a double chin, so I do apologize for that. But it's the end of the week, the end of the 7th weekly vlog. Thank you so much for watching if you've got this far, and thank you for sticking with me after my return from my little 3-week break. I cut my nose open at work tonight. Really hurts.
Anyway, so yeah, I'm going to sign off for the week now. Like I say, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, click the big thumbs up button underneath this video. And if you're not already, subscribe to my channel. And I will see you next week for number 8. Yeah? Good night.